My son. One
enemy remaining. Oh my god, you
Then summon him! Then summon!
What rank are you now with? Jet, please, answer. What rank are you?
I can't hear you because of this card.
God, the beneficent, the merciful.
Thank you for bringing me up the rough side of the mountain like Earthrow. Every knee bowed and every tongue confessed and paid homage to the monk who visit rock styles like the Lonely is dead Panonica. It's killing our Tondronica. Back from the great Yonder, the son of man and the son of Donda. I never rode the Jigs or the R6 or the Honda, but I flew my Ducati through North America like Wakanda. Earthquakes will strike this nation for what Bush did to Rwanda, what the Clintons did to Haiti, and down the street did to Ghana. It's a postland, they call me Toto Moto, I live a local. I shift the tectonic plates of the game if I lay one vocal. The God is interstellar while you fellas remain local. My bars is like the pyramid temples of Papa Volta. Sure as the DOJ confirmed Ezekiel's will, I can change the world like I cool with two pieces of steel. My sword on my microphone, I swore to the Christ stone. But when you break, they wanna say you took an L, Jose Castile. I'm in the fight here for what seemed like light years. My brother crossing thorny crown, squeeze out Christ tears. 30 pieces of silver clout, my Pierre Price tear. It's a war outside, it's a war outside. It's like the last days of Sodom and Gomorrah outside.
Tell me if you know someone that needs Jesus. We done in a lot of things. Tell me if you know someone that needs Jesus. We done in a lot of things. Tell me if you know someone that needs
Jesus. Last player standing.
Things. Tell me if you know someone that needs
Jesus. One enemy remaining.
What up, Ye? This is Larry Hoop Jr. First and foremost, I want to thank you for taking a fight for my father to the Oval Office. You might not have been the only one that could have did that, but you were the one that did do that. And with your assistance, we can continue to let the world take part in this fight. You know, to me, it kind of feels like me, my mother, my brothers, and my kids have all been incarcerated through this journey. And we haven't even been to jail. We've been looked at and treated as criminals for being a part of this family. My father's truth and the reality that he raised me in is that he wanted to make a change in this community. Because the conditions in this capitalist society is what made him, and it's what made the children of the day. After 25 years of being locked down, 23-1, my father has not called any shots from one of the most secure and segregated prisons in the world, and will not, once released, call any shots for the gates of the site. If my father's intentions were to lead us to death, destruction, and to the hell that he has had to live in for the past 26 years, man, he would be dead to me. I didn't sign up for that. I didn't stay on this journey this long for that. All my life, man, I've been waiting for my father to come home. They told me when I graduate 8th grade, he'll be home. Then they told me when I graduate from high school, he'll be home. I went away to Morris Brown, I graduated, and he still ain't home. Now I'm a dope. And my daughter went away to college, graduated. He's still not home. Now even more than that, my son, he graduated 8th grade, and we still waiting. Matter of fact, he hasn't hugged, kissed, or touched any of his grandchildren.